Honest, real, raw, true conversation and prayer with God.
You go down into the water, and when you do, the old person dies. You come up out of the water as a new creation in Jesus Christ.
Hey, welcome to Church Experience. Thank you so much for spending part of your weekend with us. Now is a great time to grab your weeklies and head to your seats if you haven't already, because the service starts in 90 seconds.
I'm here to tell you today that God wants to set you free.
Oh, yeah.
He wants to set you free.
Pursue a relationship with Him. Grow in your walk with Him. Get closer to Him. Spend more time with Him because He's better. If you want your life to get better, then get around the one who is better. Get around Jesus. Get around the one who has power to change and transform your life. Get around the one who has the perfect grace for you and the perfect love for you and the perfect joy for your soul. Listen, He is better.
are so happy to see you today. I'm looking forward to today's impacting service. During the service, you may have some questions, comments, prayer requests. Go to churchexperience.tv/connect or pull out your camera app and scan the QR code to connect with us. Or you can even hit that subscribe button if you always want to know what's going on here at CE. We are always glad to hear from you, get back to you, and be praying for you. Guess what time it is? Time to spend time worshiping God through songs. Let's jump in, participate, and let God speak to us during this time.
Seen what you can do, oh God. things you've done before in greater measure. You will do again, 'cause there's no prison wall you can't break through, no mountain you can't move. All things are possible, and there's no broken body you can't raise, no soul that you can't save. All things are possible. The darkest night, you can light it.
Father, Lord, We thank you for who you are. We thank you for reviving the broken things in us and giving us that glimmer of hope. Hope that only you could provide. Father God, I just pray that our hearts would awaken to glorify you, God. That chains will fall. Chains that bind us will fall off, Lord. That we will live for you. That you allow us to be the light so that people can see and experience you. Father God, I just pray that people all around the world will know to love you, to know about you. We love you so much, God, and it is in your powerful name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's give God one a big thunderous applause. Come on, we can do a little bit better than that. Hallelujah. I'm so excited about what God is doing in the house of the Lord on this morning. I feel like preaching. Look at your neighbor and say, it's so good to see you. Come on, turn around, tell a few people, it's so good to see you. Show all of your pearly whites. No place I'd rather be than CE on a Sunday morning. If you have your Bibles, let's go to Psalms 46. Psalms 46. Psalms 46. And I'm going to begin reading at verse 10. Psalms 46 and 10. When you have it, say, I've got it. I see a few pages turning. For those who still have paper Bibles, this generation has a lot of digital Bibles. Anybody got paper Bibles still? Come on. It's good to get a paper Bible, amen. All right. We're going to kick off in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And it reads, he says, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We love you. We magnify you. We give you glory, honor, and praise. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. The title of today's message is, I must be still. I must be still. I must be still. No matter what you are facing, we have to have confidence. We must believe. We must have faith that God has our back, no matter what we are facing. Some of us may have experienced a rough week. Put your hands in the air if you just kind of had some challenges this week, or just even this past couple weeks or past couple months. That's a majority of the people in the room. Hallelujah. There is a word from the Lord for whatever it is that you are dealing with. The word of God is so important. How many know that we need a word? The word of God is so important. Hebrews 4 and 12 says, it says, for the word of God is alive and active and sharper than any double-edged sword. It penetrates even the dwindling soul and the spirits and joints and the marrow. It judges the thoughts and the attitudes of the heart. Everybody say, I need a word. The word of God gives guidance. And in Psalms 119 and 105, it says, your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Look at another neighbor and say, I need a word. In Psalms 119 and 105, it gives direction about how we need the word of God to direct our lives. In Isaiah 55 and 11, it says, God's word is sure. It means that you can trust in the word of God. It says, so is my word that goes out of my mouth. I will trust in it, and it will not return empty, but it will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent. The word, there is a word for whatever situation that you are facing. I don't care what you have, what challenges you might be in. There is a word for that. In Matthew 4 and 4, it says the word is life. It says there, Jesus answered. It says, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but on every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. We need the word of God like never before. It's time for us to dig in the word of God. And that is what's going to give us confidence to keep going. Look at your neighbor and say, keep going. So get in the word. Get in the word. The word is something that won't ever go out of style. The word of God will always be relevant. In this passage, Psalms 40, 46 and 10. Judah was experiencing some difficulties. Judah was experiencing some challenges. They were surrounded by 185,000 footmen of the Assyrian army. And the Assyrian army during that time were some of the baddest, one of the baddest armies that existed. And not only could they fight, they did wicked stuff. They sent like notes and told you how bad they wanted to whoop you. They sent hate mail and told you, hey, I'm gonna mess you up. I'm gonna beat you down. I'm gonna destroy you. That's what Sennacherib and the Assyrian army wanted to do. There are situations in our lives. Some of us feel like we're surrounded by problems, challenges, struggles, disagreements, and confusion. Today, there is a word for it. You must be still. You must be still. God is everything that you need. This passage, Psalms 46 and 1, says, God is our refuge and strength, ever-present help in a time of trouble. Some of the translations say a very present help. Help means assurance. Help means assistance.
I'm so glad that God is present. There have been some people that have left us hanging. There are some people that haven't been that have forsaken us and dropped the ball. One thing that I love about God, that he will never leave us, nor will he ever forsake us. Help is available for whatever you're facing. Help is available. The Bible says, cast your cares to the Lord. So many times we try to hold on to our issues, our challenges, when we're supposed to cast it. What does it mean to cast it? To throw it. To thrust it to the Lord. You weren't meant to carry that burden. You weren't meant to carry that weight. You weren't meant to carry that stress. Leave it today. I just decree and declare you won't leave the same way you came here. He's our refuge. Ever present. Some translations say very present. That means a word named mayal, which is means very abundance. That means there's abundance of help when you call on the Lord. There is an abundance of help when you dig into the word. It says, verse 2, therefore, we will not fear. Though the earth give way to the mountains and fall to the heart of the sea, through the waters roar and form and foam, and the mountains quake with their surging. You don't have to fear. What in your life are you facing that's intimidating? What in your life are you facing that's a challenge? If it's too big for you, it's just right for God. Okay. I'll say that one more time. If it's overwhelming for you, it's because God wants to take it off your hands. How many times have we tried to hold and say, it's crushing me, and you tried to hold on to it? Give it to God. Give your family to God. Give your career to God. Give your life to God. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Oh, my. Give it to God. Fear. What has tried to discourage you? What has been a challenge? What? Think about this. Give it to God. Have you prayed about it? Have you sought the word of God about it? Let this be a message where it prompts you to get in the word. Let the Bible, the paperback version. I'm just messing with y'all. Y'all can do the digital version. That was a joke. Let the word of God be your best friend in this season. Before you talk to your friends about your problem, that's cool. But what does the word say? The word of God never gives bad advice. You don't have to fear. Don't have to be scared. So knock her out. Was a bad boy. Everything that you need is found in his word. Verse 4 reads, I'm just walking the text. It says, there is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy place where the Most High dwells. Talk about this for a second. There's a river. Everybody say, there's a river. But there's no river in Jerusalem. Look, time, there was no river. Why? Because Jesus is the river that makes glad the city of our God. What do rivers bring? Rivers bring water. Yeah, come on. Somebody say water. Rivers bring life. Some of us have been in some dry places. We've been in some dry seasons. You feel like you've been experienced some famine. God is that river. Come on. He wants to pour out his spirit. A river, there's a river of love. There's a river of joy that wants to hit. That wants to hit your life today. Yes, it is. God is a river. Psalms 46 and 5 says, God is within her. It says, she will not fall. God will help her at the break of day. Some translations say, God is with her. I will not be moved. I like that. What has tried to move you? What has tried to grasp your authority? Ooh, it's quiet in this room. What has tried to overwhelm you? What has tried to take your peace? As you stand on the word, you shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that gives fruit in its season. That's what the Bible says. A tree planted like by the rivers of water. I'm thinking about a palm tree. A palm tree has some of the strongest roots. Got some people from Florida that's here. Some people that live have been near water before. One of the things about palm trees are rarely do you see them break. They might bend over. They might sway. But they're not, rarely are they breaking. In this season, you're not going to break. Come on, look at your neighbor and say, you're not going to break in this season. The enemy has tried to overwhelm you with discouragement, with fear, with anxiety, with stress. You're not going to break down. You're about to break through. You're about to break through. You shall not be moved. In this season, refuse to be fearful. Why? Because God has your back. He's sending help. An army. This is what they were facing. Jehovah Sabaoth is the God of war. And he's going to fight on our behalf. It says, God is our refuge and strength. That means he's our high place. Everybody say, he's my high place. It says, he's the Lord of hosts. That's a military term. It might just be you, but there's angel armies that are backing you. Whew. That's how you fight your battles. Standing on the word of God. No weapon formed. Come on here. No weapon formed against you shall ever prosper. Why? Not in your strength, but standing on the word of God. No matter what you're facing, you got to stand. You got to stand on the word of God. It says the Lord of hosts. Sennacherib is intimidating. big and bad. So Sennacherib, it didn't end well for him. No matter how big the challenge is, the enemy that you're facing is a defeated foe. You have to realize that we are victorious. Ephesians says we're seated at the high place. No longer will you have to be fearful again. We just have to realize the authority that we carry. That means God has given us authority. God has given us dominion for whatever it is that we may be facing. This word today is for two people, two groups of people. I must be still. It's not just for the enemy saying, you got to back. But it's also for the people of God as well. It's a twofold word. Be still. Know that he is God. The same God that has brought you out of past chapters is the same God that will deliver you now. It says in verse 7, it says, the Lord Almighty is with us. God of Jacob is our fortress. This messed me up. Why is he talking about Jacob in the middle of this passage? What does Jacob mean? What does that name mean? Jacob means trickster. Jacob's name means deceiver. What does he say? He's the God of Jacob. Is our fortress. That means he's a God of covenant. Even to the ones that sin. How many times have you messed up? And he still loves you. All we have to do is be still and run back to his arms. No matter how many times we tried to deceive. No matter how many times we tried to get over. How many wars have you started? It says, it's twofold. He makes war cease to end the ends of the earth. He breaks the bow and the shatters of the spears. He burns the shields with fire. There's peace that's about to hit your life. The Holy Spirit is a comforter. God is releasing in this room. Lift your hands. We can lift our hands. God is releasing peace that even surpasseth all understanding. What report did you receive? What is it that you are facing? Peace is hitting your family. The enemy has to back. It might not be an army that you're facing. It might just be a struggle. What warfare are you facing? Peace is hitting that area of warfare. Come on, let's stand up. You got angel armies. We'll call the worship team around. You got angel armies surrounding you. Surrounding. We're going to go back into that song. That's how we, it's not a flesh fight. It's a faith fight. The Bible says we wrestle not against flesh and blood. It's not a people fight. The weapons of our warfare are not fleshly, are not carnal, but they're mighty through God, through the pulling down of strongholds. Everything that you need is going to be found through the word of God. For every situation, you need a word. I might not have hit your topic and called it out exactly.
Thank you. Before our usher team comes forward to receive our tithes and offerings and response cards, here's a few important things happening with our CE family. Actively serving not only brings us closer to God, but helps us fulfill our purpose by making a real difference in others' lives. Through serving with church experience, you'll use the unique ways that God has gifted you to help create welcoming environments where He can change lives. There are opportunities to serve in frontline, music and arts, kid and student experience, outreach and causes, life groups, and operations. To learn more about one of these serving teams, check the serving teams bubble on the back of your response card. As our ushers come forward to collect our response cards and receive our tithes and offerings, our generosity creates more opportunities for people to experience a life-changing relationship with Jesus, and there is no greater impact that we can make together. The Bible teaches that we worship the Lord by bringing Him our tithe, which is the first 10% of any income we receive. Anything above and beyond our tithe is an offering. When we give of our tithes and offerings, we are fueling life transformation in Jesus' name. One way to consistently give of our tithes and offerings is by establishing recurring giving on the CE website or the app. Let's honor God together through our giving and pray that more people will find hope and life in Jesus Christ. Thank you for being on mission with us to help more people experience a full life in Jesus Christ.
Made a commitment during the service, and we'd love to have you reach out and tell us about it by scanning the QR code. If you have questions, comments, prayer requests, you can scan that same code or go to churchexperience.tv/connect. Hope to hear from you. If you haven't checked out our CE social media, Instagram, Facebook, website, or app, make sure you do, or go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I've loved our time together, and we can't wait to see you next week.